So can we talk about how sleep deprivation affects your immune system? I'm Cristy Code Red, author, entrepreneur, retired professional boxer.
I am Carrie Thompson, MSNRN, and the Chief Operations Officer here at Code Red.
I created a nutrition program that enables people to lose 10% of their body weight every month without shakes, pills, diet foods, or even exercise. In this video, we're gonna go over what is actually happening to your body when you're sleep deprived. And then we'll go over the fastest way to get over sleep deprivation and boost your immune system. And by the way, it's not just a nap. And last, we'll cover how to further support your immune system.
Cristy, I like to call this the perfect storm. That's what sleep deprivation does to your body and especially your immune system. So let me describe it to you. You don't sleep well. You have several nights of not sleeping. What is actually happening in your body? You don't need to go get the energy drink. You don't need to try to nap your way and halfway sleep through work. It actually goes a lot deeper than what people realize. What is happening is your body perceives a lack of sleep as a threat. Yes, it does. So way back in the caveman days, when your body perceived a threat, it was, for instance, the saber-toothed tiger coming after you. So your body does not know the difference. Right now, it's the same response between the saber-toothed tiger and between you not getting sleep. And I think this is really important to realize. A lot of people run around like a badge of honor. Mommies don't sleep, I'll sleep when I'm dead, and all this other baloney that I hear. But what you don't realize is that you are setting yourself up for metabolic issues later on. So this threat is perceived. We have this threat, your body immediately starts to produce cortisol, which is a stress hormone. That has a whole cascade of effects that people way smarter than me have researched, but some of them include hanging on to body fat, especially belly fat. Why do you ask belly fat? Where are your vital organs? Yep, right in there. So if that saber-toothed tiger is going to stab you, it wants to shunt blood and hang on to fat that might protect you from an injury. So viscera also increases your blood glucose levels. Instantly, they go up when you're stressed. And that would be triggered by a lack of sleep. Why is that? Because your body says, oh, Cristy, she just got stabbed by that saber-toothed tiger. She may need to run a mile to the next cave person to help her. So she needs some extra glucose. So immediately your glucose levels go up. There is a whole cascade of metabolic and hormonal things that take place when your body senses stress. And like I said before, lack of sleep is stress in the body.
I'll just tell you what happened to me recently. We just had a stressful, I don't even like using the word stress because I think it's overused. I handle stress, I think, really well, so I very rarely have this happen to me. First of all, I'm a really good sleeper. And second of all, I handle stress. So we had a stressful situation happen and I had gone 3 days on very little sleep. Let me tell you, by the end of that third day, I was starting to break down. I knew I was on the verge of getting sick. My weight was creeping up each day, a pound each day, for no reason, except for that. Like, for no reason as in I'm not eating Doritos or something. And I just was feeling worse and worse. My body was breaking itself down. So I was right on the verge of getting sick because you shorten that sleep, you're just gonna break your body down and you're gonna be susceptible to a cold. Or I was starting to get foggy brained and I maybe roll an ankle because I'm not paying attention. I mean, heaven forbid you cross that yellow line and you hit somebody. It's really a serious problem.
It's a very serious problem. And if we're looking at an immune system level, you are more likely to get sick if you are not sleeping well. That just makes sense. You know how you don't get good sleep for a couple days and all of a sudden you have a sniffle. Then all of a sudden it's a cough and it just compounds. It's very important to realize that every time you force your body to go through this stressful situation where you're turning on certain hormones and you're producing cortisol, it is hard on your body. And your body doesn't have that energy then to effectively fight off a cold as well as it would if you face the day. It's just like, guys, if your kids are whining at you and you had a great night's sleep and then you turn and you say, mommy will be with you in 5 minutes. Well, if you're exhausted, you're going to be like, oh, I'll be with you in a minute. You know, you're yelling and it's because you're not properly prepared to deal with that stressor. Same thing happens to your immune system when you don't sleep. You can't properly prepare and deal with those stressors that come in that might affect you because you're not topped off. Your tank isn't full.
And you're little soldiers. I like to look at the immune system as little soldiers. You just haven't set up your soldiers. You haven't prepared your soldiers for success.
Absolutely.
How can you expect your body to fight for you when you are running it down? And that's what happens when you don't sleep. Because a lot of things happen when you sleep. You recharge, replenish. You restore, all those re-words.
I used to fly from Alaska to Idaho. I would fly all night because that's the best way. If you have to fly from Alaska anywhere, you might as well sleep on the plane. Of course, you don't sleep well. So I would arrive at Cristy's house getting ready for a Code Red event, and I would be dehydrated a little bit because I was kind of awake, kind of not. You're not always drinking water at night. The other thing is I was tired and I was hungry.
Ooh.
So when you do not sleep, your body thinks it needs glucose. So it tells you, you need to eat. And of course, let me just say what Dr. Mark Hyman said. He said, I never worked a night shift at the ER, got off shift being exhausted and thought, I need a big plate of broccoli. No, you think I want to stop and grab a dozen donuts and eat those on the way home. That is designed into your system. That is designed into your system for quick energy. That is a natural body response. I'm not going to get to Cristy's house and be like, can you cook me up a big plate of broccoli and I'm going to, you know, drink some coffee and go to bed. I know I was hungry and thirsty. So beware, moms and dads and people trying to have a good metabolism and a good immune system, that you are going to be hungry if you do not sleep. It is a natural response.
So before we move on to the next part, if you like this video, totally subscribe to this channel and give me a thumbs up. I produce content like this all the time. You're gonna love it. If you wanna better support your immune system, one way to do that, a big way to do that, is to wear your blue light blocking glasses to block the blue light so that you can sleep better. So we are wearing Swanwick blue light blocking glasses. I'm wearing the day wear, Carrie is wearing the night wear glasses. And during the day, if you are surrounded by devices like I am, and you wanna reduce eye strain, and you wanna reduce headaches, wear your blue light blocking glasses. And at night, wear your night wear glasses.
We know that melatonin, a hormone produced in the brain, actually decreases significantly when you are exposed to blue light in the evenings. So I understand. You want to be on your phone. I get it. You have work to do. A couple hours before bed, get these, put them on, and let your body help you naturally get ready for bed by using the melatonin that you can produce in your own brain.
And people watching this video, you can get 15% off, which is a really significant savings, I think. I think it's a good savings, by entering the code CODERED15. On the link provided below. So get yourself a pair of good quality Swanwick glasses. This company is family owned out of Australia, and we've partnered up with them for years now. They produce a great product for our rebels and our community. I don't go anywhere without my blue light blocking glasses. I always, always put them on at least 2 hours before bed because I do enjoy being on my iPad. I enjoy watching nature shows and watching baking shows and makeup tutorials. I do. And so if you're like me, get your blue light blocking glasses on.
It is not reasonable for some people. We tell them, put your devices away. Some people it's just not reasonable for. And I understand that. The work demands and the life demands that we all have, they're very significant. So it's okay. Just put blue light blocking glasses on and you'll be fine.
And this is gonna further support your immune system because you will sleep.
Yes.
You have to sleep or your body does not get what it needs to build itself back up and take you through the day. You know, I am amazed at people that put such a high demand on their bodies, raising kids, working full-time outside the home, taking care of a farm, taking care of animals, taking care of chickens, and yet they do not get adequate sleep. And then you get mad at your body because you're gaining weight,
right.
You're sick,
right.
All these things are going wrong. Well, you ain't giving your body what it needs.
That is absolutely true, Cristy. And the other thing to keep in mind, that we've all heard the horror stories of the way that they torture people, the global they, is sleep deprivation. And I have always said I would have made a terrible special forces officer or agent in the military because I would have been 10 hours no sleep. I'd have been singing like a bird. My name is Carrie Thompson. This is my social security number. I'd have never made it a day. I mean, you could waterboard me, whatever. Like, I would not do well with sleep deprivation. And that is a common thing among soldiers. My husband's in the Army active duty, and he has gotten used to not sleeping. But this is why we have hypertension. This is why we have sleeping problems. This is why we have increased depression. Mm-hmm. This is why we have problems with being able to perform sexually. These things are linked to lack of sleep.
During our 10-pound takedown, we talk extensively about sleep and the immune system, so we would love to have you on our monthly challenge. Every month, we have rolling challenges, so you just need to click the link and join our next challenge. You can lose at least 10 pounds in 30 days without shakes, pills, diet foods, or even exercise, so check it out in the link below.